I became an educator because I was volunteering as a young person to teach adults to read in Washington, D.C. And I soon realized, learning from my students, that it wasn't that they didn't try. It wasn't that they didn't go to school. It was that they learned differently and nobody had addressed that. And to me, that just seemed like such a great injustice. Nobody had dug down deep enough to find the key to their lock. The learning advocate is coming right when it's supposed to in my life. It's almost the culmination of having my own struggles in school, being compared to faster achievers than I was. It was kind of hard. Like, why is everybody getting it but me? But I had determination. So I graduated from Harvard University's Graduate School of Education with a master's in human development and psychology, concentrating on language and literacy. That was, of course, a game-changing platform for me, right? Deeply researching and constantly learning about how we learn, how our brains work, digging down into the neuroscience of it all. Then only to later find out, 20 years later, that actually I have ADHD and my brain is organized differently too, with this wealth of information and understanding about psychology and development. And I set out on a journey to work with all kinds of students, which I have in all kinds of areas, no matter what their socioeconomic circumstances are, culturally, internationally, to really get a sense of those differences and how to reach them. When you look at the certifications that I have or pieces of writing that I've written, you can see that lifelong learner and growth over time, because I'm always searching for another key, for another lock.